Good evening and welcome to Up South. We have a power-packed show with stories from all over South India with me, T.S. Sudhir. In fact, two stories from South India that will give you an idea of the political culture in India. In fact, a little later on in the show, we will have a story from Andhra Pradesh on how the Aam Aadmi's money has been used to fund iPhone 6 handsets for all the 215 MLAs and MLCs in Andhra Pradesh. In fact, on Up South, we ask whether this kind of a splurging by a cash-strapped government was really necessary. In fact, we would want you to call in and share your views with us on Up South. But our top story on Up South this evening comes from Tamil Nadu. In fact, from the hill station of Ooty in Tamil Nadu. At around 4:35 yesterday evening, a group of about 25 volunteers, 15 women and 10 women, were actually cleaning a wall near the collector's office in Ooty in Tamil Nadu. In fact, the wall had been defaced because of graffiti and posters greeting Jayalalitha on her birthday on the 24th of February. The 15 women and 10 women were actually doing their social service, and that's when a group of AIADMK activists arrived, abused them for daring to remove birthday wishes for their leader and threw the bucket of paint on the volunteers. And mind you, this should ideally be the work of the municipal workers of the Tamil Nadu government, something they do not do. And these volunteers do this in their free time. On Up South, we want to ask, is this really the culture of the AIADMK, the ruling party in Tamil Nadu? And is this the lumpen behavior that they would want to seek votes for in April in the Tamil Nadu Assembly elections next year? Joining me now from Ooty is Shobana Chandrasekhar, founder of the Make Ooty Beautiful Foundation, who was the target of that attack and verbal abuse. Ma'am, this is an extremely shocking incident which you are reporting from Ooty. Your group has been doing this for almost a year now. Were you taken by surprise by the kind of verbal abuse that was showered on you and your other volunteers?
Yes, we were completely taken by surprise. We did not expect it at all. We were just going about doing our duty as citizens. We've been doing regular cleanups for the past 10 months every week. And this week was like any other week. A group of volunteers went up to a wall that we had been cleaning previously. And we went to finish what we had started last week. And all of a sudden, we had a group of politicians and their henchmen descend upon us and hurl abuse at us. So we were completely surprised, and the abuse that they hurled on us was extremely filthy language. They used sexually suggestive language, they used language to abuse the community of the volunteers, and it was just completely unprecedented and unexpected. So, and our volunteers did not expect it, and they were frankly very frightened, because not only did they abuse us verbally, they also kicked all our buckets of paint, they threw our implements around, and they threatened us with physical abuse if we didn't leave immediately.
Right, I'm absolutely shocked, Shobana, to hear what you have to say about the incident which happened in Ooty yesterday evening. In fact, I would like to tell our viewer that this wall actually belonged to the BSNL, and BSNL's permission had been taken by the Make Ooty Beautiful Foundation for actually cleaning up the wall. But when the matter was reported to the police officer, instead of taking action against the AIADMK activists, actually asked Shobana whether she had written permission from the BSNL for cleaning up their wall. Shobana, this is an absolutely ridiculous reaction to a terrible incident of verbal abuse and assault. Now, if Jayalalitha were to actually hear you now, what would you like to tell the former Chief Minister of Tamil Nadu?
Well, I would like to remind the Chief Minister that she is also a woman, like most of the volunteers who were there yesterday. And it is absolutely not all right to be threatened by the ruling party, who are other representatives of the people. And we would also like to say that, you know, public property, the government should be happy when citizens want to join hands with the government and want to make the town a better place for everybody. And, you know, treating public walls like it belongs to the party. Once the name of a party is painted on a wall, that does not mean that the wall belongs to the party, and that forevermore that it has to, you know, just have their names on it. Yes. So,
Right, Shobhna Chandrasekhar, thanks a lot for joining us there from Ooty. We would continue to track this story, and hopefully the AIADMK will have the decency to actually apologize and react to this story which you are reporting from Ooty. Shobhna, thanks a lot for joining us on Up South. Our next story on Up South is from Andhra Pradesh, and our phone lines are open for you to call in and share your views. And this is a luxury that Andhra Pradesh could have done without. It's a cash-strapped government bleeding after the bifurcation of Andhra Pradesh. But what the Andhra Pradesh government has decided to do is to follow a tradition which has been happening for many years. But that's really no excuse to actually splurge over 1 crore rupees to gift 215 iPhone 6 handsets to all the MLAs and MLCs in Andhra Pradesh. Even at a discounted rate of 50,000 rupees per phone, this works out to a bill of over 1 crore rupees. The question therefore to ask is, how fair is it for Chandrababu Naidu to spend your money and my money to gift himself and his tribe that to one of the most expensive mobile handsets?
Most efficient device, and our people's representatives, we have to use it in order to geotag, in order to, you know, upload pictures, in order to communicate, in order to check their mails, in order to be on the social media, connect with the constituents, etc. So I think it's perfect. There's nothing wrong in this.
It's a very expensive handset, especially at a time when AP government is really not financially rich.
How expensive is expensive? It's not very expensive, but you see the kind of value that it gives to our people's representative, it is worthwhile. And we are in financial difficulties, but we are not destitute.
But I don't think, we have to emulate the, we have to behave in a way where people should emulate us as examples.
And you don't think you are setting the right example?
I don't think so.
Right, our phone lines are open for you to call in and share your views. In fact, our first caller is Venugopal calling in from Hyderabad. Mr. Venugopal, please go ahead.
Yes, sir. Thank you for giving the opportunity. This CM is going to the center with a begging bowl for money and is living on overdraft even to pay the salaries. To splurge the money in this kind of way is heinous, actually. And who gave him the... They are not accountable at all. Both the CMs of this Andhra Pradesh and Telangana, they have given a 43% raise to state government employees and lot of raises to all their people, as if the government is for government employees and for the MLAs only. They are not thinking of common men. I think there is no need for giving these iPhones to the MLAs and MLCs. Some of them don't even know how to use them. And if they really need them, they can very well definitely afford them. You should give something to the poor and common people, not to these people who can afford these things. I think the government should...
Yes, Mr. Venugopal, your point is well taken. Thanks a lot for calling in. Our next caller is Srinivas, also calling in from Hyderabad. Please go ahead, sir. Okay, we have lost that phone line with Srinivas. Vijay calling in from Hyderabad. Mr. Vijay, what do you have to say?
Sir, I just have one thing to say. It's not only this time, sir. From past 5 years, I've been giving the same thing. Every year, they either get an iPad, they get a laptop, they get printer or whatever it is. They do have phones, they do have everything with them, but still, why do they have to use people's money for that? They find it as an opportunity.
Right.
Sir. They just find it as an opportunity to loot people's money. That's it. Even I'm very sure, even if you ask any of the representative now as why you're doing this, they'll just give an answer saying, what's wrong in it? It's just 1 crore. We have so much budget. There's nothing you can talk about this.
Right, Vijay, thanks for the points that you're making. In fact, I would like to point out that Andhra Pradesh has a fiscal deficit of over 17,500 crore rupees. Our next caller is Krishnamurthy calling in from Mumbai. Please go ahead, sir.
See, when I hear this kind of news, what I feel is that this no amount of media interception on this is going to change the outlook of these people, because they may be educated, but they have not got the values associated with what they have to do. Forget deficit or surplus. The issue is very simple. Should we spend money of the public on issues which have no relevance. Can you not buy a mobile which you can survive? You can survive with even an ordinary. The officer was justifying, it gives value. I just don't understand what kind of value addition is to these people who have to bring in value in the assembly by providing the right direction for development, growth, etc. It is amazing
right.
that these people, and one more thing, I am very sorry, by providing this information and finally nothing is going to happen, it will only encourage them to go ahead, they will say, okay, media will come for some time and we can continue to do this.
Right. You know? Right. Mr. Krishnamurthy, thanks a lot for calling in. In fact, what's happening is that the messaging doesn't seem to be very right. The message that is going out to the people of Andhra Pradesh, in fact, Chandrababu Naidu has been asking the people of Andhra Pradesh to make sacrifices because a new capital has to be built and there's a huge cost to be incurred. So in that sense, he's not really sending the right message. Our next caller is Mr. Maninder calling in from Hyderabad. Please go ahead, sir.
Hello? Hello?
Yes, sir. Please go ahead.
Yes, Mr. Maninder, please go ahead. Maninder, I'm speaking from Hyderabad.
Yes.
Hello?
Yeah, please go ahead, sir. I can hear you.
Yeah.
Yes, I can hear you. Please go ahead.
Yeah, see, my view is that, just look at the hypocrisy of the politicians. This morning, Modi was telling the people to leave the subsidy for the LPG so that the money which goes into the subsidy will actually be used for the poor. And over here in Andhra Pradesh, his ally Chandrababu Naidu is not distributing iPhones, iPad to their MLAs. So means I really want to know that why, instead of doing this, why don't they just use their money for the poor and help them out? I mean, this is a sheer
right,
case of hypocrisy of the politicians of India. And I must say that they are
right.
totally misusing the money.
Right, that's an interesting point that you make, Mr. Maninder. In fact, all of us have got mail saying that we could actually give up the LPG subsidy. The next caller is Raghunath calling in from Bengaluru. Please go ahead, sir.
Hello, good evening, Mr. Sudhir.
Good evening, sir. Please go ahead.
Good evening, Mr. Sudhir. Raghunath here. See, there are two things you pointed. One thing about the defacing of walls at Ooty is totally unacceptable, and Ms. Jayalalitha and the AIADMK workers have to apologize for it. And
yes, sir.
Secondly, with regarding to the distribution of cell phones is totally unacceptable and totally undemocratic when people are struggling for two square meals. Chandrababu Naidu circulating this kind of cell phones is not acceptable. And
right,
thirdly, ML and MLCs are very rich people. They are not from the poor background. So why do they need to
right.
be given all these things? Is my question to Mr.
Okay.
Chandrababu Naidu and
right.
Ms. Jayalalitha.
Huh? Right. Thanks, Mr. Raghunath, for calling in. Our last caller in this segment is Srinivas, who is calling in from Hyderabad. Mr. Srinivas, please go ahead.
Yeah. Namaste. I'm Shama here.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. It is very strange that they have taken money, public money, and using it for freebies. When the government is not able to provide clean government hospitals and our hospitals are sinking, I don't know why they should give this freebies to the MLAs. I really don't understand.
Right. Right. Mr. Srinivas, thanks a lot for joining us. In fact, we do hope that the Andhra Pradesh Chief Minister Chandrababu Naidu is listening, because the message going out is that this was something absolutely unnecessary. News now from Karnataka, where the state government found itself on the back foot all of last week because of the opposition pushing for a CBI probe in the DK Ravi death case. But now the Congress government has decided to go on the offensive and is planning to recommend to the centre to open up CBI cases in which BJP and Janata Dal secular leaders are involved. In fact, these include corruption charges against H.D. Kumaraswamy, violence after actor Rajkumar's death, rape case against former BJP Minister Hallappa, irregularities in the Bengaluru Municipal Corporation where the BJP is in a majority.
In several ways, already in Lokayukta, even in after Supreme Court interference about our mining activities in Karnataka, all those things already they searched. But if they want again to hand it over once more to CBI, if they have any other information, after this government formation, I welcome this government to hand over even my 150 crore bribe charge against me to CBI.
Some of the Congress MLAs did make a request that, you know, so many sensitive cases during the regime of BJP and Mr. Kumaraswamy also were not handed over to CBI, and which were much more, I think, more critical or more important than what has happened with Mr. D.K. Ravi. So even on those cases, they never gave it to CBI. So some of the MLAs said that, you know, we should consider now, since the BJP is trying to make political capital over the death of D.K. Ravi, trying to use it for political gains. The Congress also should do it, but I think the Chief Minister will not. I think he will take a call depending on the actual issue at hand.
In fact, TV Today had also accessed the statement given by the lady IAS officer in the D.K. Ravi case to the CID, and in fact it reveals that there could be a personal angle to the death case, and that is something which will have to be probed by the CBI. But the opposition is not very happy with the fact that all these statements have been leaked to the media. Joining me now is my colleague Pratibha Raman from Bengaluru. Pratibha, what has been the opposition reaction? Because they were pushing for a CBI probe. They were pushing for the fact that the CID status report should not be made public or even tabled in the assembly.
Exactly. So they, right from the time when the government wanted to table the CID's interim report in the assembly, the fight has been on. In fact, the issue is still being fought in the court. And that is why the opposition parties are crying foul, because they seem to think that, number one, this is a deliberate attempt by the government to make sure that there is a tone that has been set before the investigation is taken over by the CBI. And number two, they want to protect themselves because they are the only ones who've been saying that this death is caused due to personal angle and not the mafia angle, as people have been pointing out.
Right. Pratibha Raman, thanks a lot for joining us from Bengaluru. That's it then on Up South this Friday evening. News and updates will continue on Headlines Today.